With the AI chatbot ChatGPT going viral in the news recently, I decided to check out what it's like at creating Excel formulas. And it's actually quite good at creating them, but can easily get tripped up with creating more complex formulas. I have a really basic sheet here, and I'm going to see if I can use AI to fill in some of the data. ChatGPT is currently in a free research preview, so all you need to do is sign up for an OpenAI account and use it for free. I'm going to get it to output the first name from cell A. The prompt I'm going to use is write an Excel formula that returns the first word from cell A. Only provide the formula, do not provide an explanation. Sometimes it will give a lot of unnecessary text. If I copy in the formula, that works perfectly, and I'll fill down and it will fill the rest. So next up, I'm going to get it to return everything for the last word. Write an Excel formula that returns everything after the first word. I'll copy the output. That also works. Next up, we're going to get it to write a formula to determine the age of the person. And we're going to use this based on the date in cell F2 as a starting point. So write an Excel formula to give the age of the person based on their date of birth in cell F2. And let's see what it comes up with. Copy that and it works. Next up, we're going to just get it to extract the email domain. For that, we can just go back, write an Excel formula that returns everything after the character at. We'll copy that back in. Oh, we need to do that from D2. So I will, from cell D2, I will write, just in case I'm too lazy to update that manually. And there we go. So there you have it. These are some very basic examples of how to use this. And if you want to see more examples, then please like this video and drop a comment below. Let us know what you've used it for, if you've tried this out with some Excel formulas. And of course, the examples in this video were quite basic. But if you are rusty with the syntax of Excel formulas, then this might save you a whole lot of time. Though keep in mind that it might generate incorrect formulas, particularly if you ask it to do stuff that's more complex. This is a video from exceltutorial.net. If you like the video and want to see more, then please subscribe and we'll see you in the next one.